Welcome to the channel Timid Color. We are on process of making this scene. In the previous videos, you have seen how to model it and unwrap it in Maya, and then how to sculpt it in ZBrush. Today, we are going to do the texturing of this scene in Substance Painter. If you missed any of those videos, all the links are given in the description. So let's get started with Substance Painter. In the last session, I showed you how to export the hut to Substance Painter. But after that, I have included my tree, the base, and the stones also in that low poly and high poly meshes. Alright, before doing anything, let's go to File and create a new project. So, I want to import my OBJ, what I have created in Maya. Over here, you can select your file, and I'm importing the low poly mesh. Document resolution, make sure you are making it 2K. It will depend on you, like you can make it 2K, you can work with 4K resolution, absolutely fine. I'm keeping it 2K and click on OK. You can see this is my file I have created in Maya in the previous video. All the shortcuts in the viewport are like Maya only. So I'm using Alt and left click, and for this Alt and right click. So everything is like Maya only. Another thing, in the texture set list, you can see all my objects are in as if different layers. So if you can remember, before exporting from Maya, I have given different shaders, different Lamberts to all the objects. So it is taking the same names from the object, and definitely the object was in FBX, what I exported from Maya. So these are all different Lamberts I have given in Maya. So whatever name given over there in Maya, the same name it is taking, but over here also you can change the name. But before doing anything, let's go to texture set settings, and over here I am going to mesh maps and bake mesh maps. Here I want to bake all the maps except the thickness map. I don't want the thickness map. And over here you can browse the high definition mesh from Maya. I already exported the high definition mesh, and you just can import the same mesh. So I guess this is my high definition mesh, and you can see the naming convention, low and high, I have given this. Open and high poly mesh underscore high, low poly mesh underscore low. I have done the same thing, and bake all texture set. Okay, it is done. So what exactly happened over here? I baked all the information from the high definition mesh to this low definition model, and over here for each and everything I'm selecting over here, and you can see it is changing. So I have extracted all the normal maps, world space normal, ID I didn't create anything, ambient occlusion, curvature, position. So all the maps I extracted from each and every geometry. So now let's start with this wood, and you can see I am getting all the detailing what we created in ZBrush, or we created the high definition mesh, I am getting over here. So now let's start with the wood. So first of all, what I'll do, I'm selecting the wood from the texture list, and this is the layer option, and let's create a new layer. So this is a fill layer. So I have created a fill layer. Alright. And now the layer is selected. Come to the property. And over here in the material tab, you can see I'm having 5 different tabs or attributes. Color, height, roughness, metallic and normal. I'm clicking off normal and metal, and going to the base color and giving it a wooden color. So let's select something like this. Alright, an wooden color. and this is the roughness. Roughness will be the glossiness of the material. So let's check. I am holding shift and right click to rotate my environment. So you can see it is too glossy and wood cannot be that much glossy. So I am increasing the roughness. Now you can see the glossiness is spread, it is reduced. Fine. So this is my base color layer. I want to create a color variation in this layer. So I'll just duplicate it, Ctrl D, and going to the base color, and let's make it maybe a little bit darker, a little bit saturated towards the red. It can look a very dark wood, but that's absolutely fine. And now right click on it and add black mask to it. It is just like Photoshop. Two layers, the above layer, I'm applying mask to it. So how much I will paint with white, that will be visible. How much I will paint with black will not be visible. So now black mask I directly applied, so everything is filled with black, so nothing is visible. Right click on it, on that mask, and add fill. So what will happen in this fill, I can just connect a black and white texture, and through this texture the bottom layer will be visible. I'm going to the procedural. I guess I will get the wooden texture. So this is the wooden texture. What I'm doing, I'll just drag and drop on this, and you can see I'm getting a kind of wooden color, rather wooden texture, and this color is visible to the veins. You can do the scaling from here. If you want, you can make it more dense, but I don't want that. Maybe it can be one. Yes, this is all right. You can give a little bit rotation. So I am concentrating on this for now. All right, you can use offset if you don't like this pattern. So definitely you can use offset, and so from the another direction, offset. Now I want to paint all the groups, all the cavities. So for that, what I need to do, I'm just duplicating the same layer, and in the mask I'll just delete this wood, and this color let's make it a little darker, and also little desaturated. Fine. So right click, and this time I'm adding a generator. Now what this generator will do, it will mask the areas from the maps we have extracted. So it can mask all the occlusion area, it can mask all the curvature area, curvature in the sense edges. So like that it can mask. So in the generator over here, either you can take a metal edge or you can take the mask editor. So, or you can take the dirt. I'm taking dirt over here. So let's click on it. All right, and you can see all the cavities are taking this dark color, and this is absolutely fine. Coming to this, this is the dirt level. So dirt level, you can reduce it like this, or if you want, you can increase this. And I think you can understand, it is taking the information from the occlusion. So that's why all the connecting areas are becoming darker. And this is the contrast. If you don't want those grunge texture all over the surface, so definitely this can be used. I want to keep a little information in this area, that's why I'll not reduce it too much. So this is the grunge amount, so you can understand. So I'll reduce it. Now looking clean, this is fine. Now I'm duplicating this lighter color and keeping it at the top. All right, and make it much more lighter. I'm comparing with this color, with the base color. So it should be lighter than the base color because I'm going to paint the edges actually through this layer. So right click, again the same thing, black mask. And this time also I'm taking a generator. The generator is selected, going to the generator. And let's take mask editor. Okay, and you can see all the edges are selected this time. All right, and I'm going to the parameters. Now this is a global balance. Okay, the global controller. All right, now this is a global contrast. If you want to make it very sharp, so need to increase the contrast. Now the actual property is the curvature for the edges, so just open that. You can see I am just playing with the values. So you can see with some adjustments I have got this much. This is basically the color of the wood. If you want to reduce some of these parts, that can be eliminated through masking. So what exactly can be done? Let me check from which layer. So I guess from this layer. So what can be done? Right click, add paint, and now you can see you can actually paint over it. So I am painting white, so it is visible. And if you have taken a dirt brush maybe, so and I am pressing X and convert it to black, and now you just can paint over it. The information it is taking from occlusion, that's why these areas are too dark, so not needed this much dark areas. Anyway, so I guess you can understand this, that can be painted like this. Okay, so these are all the color layers. Now I am taking another fill layer, and this will be only the roughness. So what I am going to do, I am keeping the roughness, means only the gloss part. So at the edges the glossiness will be there, and all the cavities the glossiness will not be there. So for that what I am going to do, right click, again black mask, right click, add generator, and same metal edge I am selecting. Now how to see the glossiness, which part is getting glossiness, which part is not getting. So I am going over here and I am selecting mask, and you can see all the glossy areas. So over here also, and it has to be soft enough. Alright, going back to the material, so just press M in the keyboard. You can see how is it looking. Now the overall gloss, so shift and right click, just check, and you can see still the overall gloss is too much, isn't it? So just selecting this instead of base color, I'm selecting the roughness and reduce the overall glossiness of this layer. So approximately 50% I'm reducing. All right, this is fine. And now I'm clicking on the folder option, and like Photoshop I got the folder, selecting all these layers and just keeping inside and naming it as base wood. So this is my base wood material. So you can see, right click and create smart material. So what will happen with this? Over here we are having smart material, and you can see this is the base wood. So I am going to the next wooden part, and what I will do, I'll just drag and drop over there, so entirely it is getting the texture. Okay, now because I am working with the wood directly, I will go to the tree stem, click it on, and I will just click it off, select the tree, and let's get started with the tree. So first of all, for the tree also, I am taking a fill layer. In this case also, clicking off the normal and metal, increasing the roughness and selecting a base color. So the base color can be, now this is a living wood, so I will try to make it a little bit colorful. All right, back to the base color. Previously I changed it. Okay, so I'm just duplicating it and taking another color just for the variation. Fine, and the same thing, add black mask, and over here I'm taking a fill, and let's check which texture can be used. Just check cloud. This is all right, I guess cloud 3 can work for me. And already you can see some parts of that color is visible, so I'll just scale it. I'm hitting C in the keyboard, and you can see the mask. Previously it was like this. I think it is all right. And I'm going to the base color. So I think there is a minute change in color variation. You can see. So I guess one was fine. The scaling is all right. So the first layer, and this is a previous layer, so somewhere in between this is contrast. I guess we can increase the contrast a little bit. All right, now I'm just duplicating this another layer, and okay, in this case the roughness and height is not needed, and in this case also the same. So I'm taking a kind of olive color just to create a variation. All right, and in this cloud, it can be something else also, you can take a different texture for this. I'm just using a rotation so that the previous reddish color and this color will not be the same. Coming back to the material, and now you just can reduce the opacity so that the color variation will be visible over here. Now taking a new layer, so this was the base color. Okay, now again taking the color like the previous wood, I am going to do the same. I am going to take a very dark color and I'll fill the cavity. So right click, add black mask, right click, add generator, and let's take the mask editor. You can use dirt also, the same thing will happen. And you can see whatever I want, just the opposite is happening. So I'm going down, going to the curvature, and in the mode, instead of edges, I'm taking cavities. And you can see all the cavities are filled with this dark color. All right, now a little bit of adjustments. Okay, I guess all right. Now I'm inserting another layer. So the same thing, taking a color. So I'm picking the base color and now going to the lighter side to it. It's too saturated or too much yellow. Right click, same thing, add black mask and right click, add generator, and I'm taking a metal edge. It is too much, so wear level, just reduce it. I need very small highlight, less contrast. Alright, and now I'm reducing the opacity. So this is purely the base color. Coming to the material by pressing M in the keyboard, I'm taking another layer, the same layer, and I'm duplicating it, removing the cloud and adding another generator, and this time I'm taking light. All right, for now, just to understand, I am making it blue so that we can see what's happening. Alright, light is selected. So what's happening over here, from one direction light is hitting the surface, so it is creating a kind of layer like that. Yes, I wanted to increase it a little bit. You can see how is it looking. I don't want it everywhere, but some of the areas. Now let's change the color to olive once again. I'm keeping it just below this highlight. Over here, I want to show the bottom layer through some of the areas. So for that, I'm going to paint. So right click and take a paint layer. Coming to the individual areas, I'm painting with black. You can see wherever I'm painting with black, because of the masking, the bottom layer is visible through the green layer, and it is creating the variation. For the demo, I will leave it over here only, but while doing the production job, it will be really nice if you are painting some of the areas manually. It will look very harmonious. I need to create some connections between this red and all the way to this red. Alright, now I'm creating a folder and selecting all my layers and keeping it inside. So over there, what I did, I am taking a fill layer, clicking off everything except the roughness, if you can remember, and now mask, adding a generator and metal edge. Alright, wire level, I'm reducing it. You can see it is a little bit too much. So same thing, going to the roughness and reducing the opacity. I have to keep it but very less. back to the base color and changing the name of this folder as tree stem. So it is looking like this, a little bit colorful than this dry wood. Now let's texture the walls. So I'm clicking off all the other geometries and clicking on the walls. So first of all, the same thing, I'm creating a fill layer and clicking off normal and metal and going to the roughness, increasing it, then selecting a base color. So a kind of white but bluish white, and let's take a mid value towards the light. I'm sorry, I'm working in the base layer, so I'll just cut layer and selecting the wall and paste layer. Fine. Now we can see the color. Alright, now duplicating it and clicking off these two and go a little bit darker. Fine, you can understand I am trying to create the cavity. Right click, same thing, black mask, right click, generator and select dirt. Fine, you can see I am getting so much of information over here. And dirt level I am reducing a little bit. Alright, now duplicating this base color, and for this make sure you are clicking it off, and over here also clicking it off. And now this time a little bit lighter color. Alright, right click, black mask, right click, generator, and I'm selecting metal edge. Alright, over here also you can see the edges are seen. Wire level, reduce a little bit, it should not be too much, but the highlight information should be there. Alright, I'm selecting this darker color and duplicating it and keeping it over here at the top, and taking a paint mask. Let's go to the alphas. So maybe this one, drip, and let us check. So I am painting over here. I'm trying to create some weather stains. You can see just under the wooden plank I'm trying to create this dripping marks, and the scaling and direction can be different so that it will look natural. For this side also I have to do the same, and also for the chimney. All right, now I'm taking a folder, selecting all the layers and keeping it inside and giving it a name as wall color. So now let's go to the tiles and try to color it. First of all, let's try to create a base color. So once again selecting the tiles and creating a fill layer, clicking off everything, increasing the roughness, selecting a base color. So I will make it saturated. All right. Now I'm duplicating it and making it a little lighter and towards the orange. Little color variation you can see. So right click, black mask, and add fill. And let's select something like cloud. I'm taking this one, selecting the mask so that we can see what's happening over here. You can see color variation, and I feel it is all right. This is the base color, and you can see the color variation over here. And this is fine to me. Let's duplicate it. Going towards the red, take a very dark color, little desaturated, maybe like this. Clicking off the cloud and adding a generator, and let's take dirt. And as I told previously, the dirt is actually taking the masking from the occlusion mask. From here it is taking the information, masking edge, so you can see the difference, right? So I'm actually masking the edges. All right. And dirt level can be reduced a little bit. Now taking this color and duplicate, click it off. For everything I am doing the same thing. A base color, the variation of the base color, the cavity color, the edge color. I am trying to maintain all these four layers everywhere. So clicking off everything else. I forgot to click off this. Alright. So it has to be a little lighter and towards the yellow. Alright. And this time I am taking metal edge. Okay, this is too much. So reduce it. It has to be very less. Fine. Now, like the previous objects, I'm taking a new fill layer, clicking off everything except the roughness, and right click, black mask, right click, add a generator, and taking a metal edge. You can see it has to be very less, and the overall opacity also has to be less. All right, this is the base color. What I want over here, some scratches. So in this only, the highlight, right click and add a fill, and let's take a scratch maybe this one. You can see over here, and scaling can be a little more. All right, and over here I am making it screen, so both the alphas visible now. This is absolutely fine. And walls also ready. The woods. Okay, all right. And the tree. All right. It is looking like this. So, once again, I will come to the tree and I'll create another layer. So, add a fill layer, bring it to the top. Clicking off everything else except color, height and roughness. Now this time I am using a color, let's say green. In the height, I am selecting maybe a noise. Let's take this one, black and white spots, and I am going to the material and you can see it is looking like this. So I will reduce it. What I am trying to create, actually I am giving the hints of the moss on the tree stem. So scaling maybe a little bit more. Alright, and roughness, it has to be more. That's fine. The color I am thinking to go towards the yellow and making it little bright. The height is too much, so going to the height and reducing the height. I'll reduce it more. Right click, black mask, and then again right click, add a generator, and I am selecting light. Alright, and highlight level and light attenuation. I want to make it opaque only, quite opaque. Fine. And in this only, I am also adding a generator called dirt. I am going to the dirt and invert it. That's fine. And let's use multiply. Alright, now I am adding a paint layer and I am going to paint with some kind of noise. Select a brush. I'll just remove all these areas. Minutely, I have to paint. It has to be very random. Alright. So now I will just duplicate it, and the brush I'm making it a little dark, and I'll just delete this paint and I'll keep it at the back. Now once again just add paint. And this time, I am taking a different brush. You can see how I am getting the color from its base gradually, and also the information of the moss also looking harmonious. Alright, what I am doing now, clicking off the tree and making the woods and the wall, so the entire house is visible now, and also the tiles. copy layers and going to this old. Paste layers. You can see the moss everywhere, so we don't want the moss everywhere. So what we are going to do, so clicking off this layer, now going to the paint layer, and I am selecting once again this paint, just paint over it. And now paint a little bit here and there. The areas are not getting the green color. Alright, now this one, same, going to the paint. Alright, for all the objects, the two moss layers, I am going to duplicate like this, and I am going to paint the portions I need. So there will be a time lapse, and quickly I'll pass this portion. Alright, now you can see all the objects are looking weathered for the moss layer. And now I have to give the texture to the base. So the base is selected and creating a new fill layer, clicking off the metal and normal, increase the roughness a little bit. Now going to the color and selecting a base color, kind of brown. Now duplicating the layer, coming to the color and making it a little bit lighter. Right click, black mask, again right click and add fill. And this time I'm using a noise, black and white spot maybe. And you can see color variation on the base. Now go to the attributes and change the parameters a little bit. Once again, duplicating this layer and taking it to the top and coming to the color. Making it a little bit more darker. Right click, black mask. And in this, I am adding a generator. And this can be dirt. Now let's play with the parameters. Alright, now once again I am duplicating the moss layers. You can see some problems are there. Like the previous way, I am going to rectify it. Alright, so It is looking like this. Now let's texture the stones. Clicking on the stone layer and clicking off everything else. Taking a new fill layer. Coming to the material and clicking off metal and normal. Increasing the roughness a little bit. Now I will give it a color. Very desaturated gray kind of color I'm selecting. Now just duplicating the color layer. Again coming to the color and making it a little bit lighter. Now right click on it. Add a black mask. Again right click and add a fill. Now going to the fill and add a grunge to it. I'm selecting this grunge and dragging and dropping it over there. Now I will change the parameters a little bit. Now I am thinking to change the color of the bottom layer, making it a little bit darker so that we can see the variation, what's happening over here. And this is looking fine. Now duplicating this layer, taking it to the top, right click, add black mask, once again right click and add a generator, and this time I'm selecting dirt. You can see all the cavities are getting the dark color. Coming back to the layer one, and in the height I'm going to use a noise, maybe black and white spot. Now let's change the parameters. Going to the height and reducing the opacity. This is basically the height opacity. I'm keeping it very less. I made the base color a little bit darker, and now duplicating this lighter version and taking it up, clicking off the previous alpha and right click and adding a generator, and this time I'm selecting fiberglass. You can see I'm getting a lighter edges, and I'll just play with the parameters. This is all right. Now I will copy the moss layer to this stone also. Alright, I guess we are done with all the objects. Now we are having only one thing left, and that is to export the texture maps to Maya. Okay, so now the scene is ready to export the textures. So going to the file and export textures. And over here you can see all the different objects are getting different textures because I have created the UV set in that way. And what kind of file format you need, you have to decide over here. So it can be PNG, it can be TGA. Over here I am taking it Targa, and everything is fine, and just export. Okay, it is done. Now I'll just open the folder. I also exported the textures in JPEG. You can see this one is for the tiles, and this one is for the wooden planks, and this one is for the tree. You can see the moss layer. This one is for the base, and this one is for the walls, and this one is for the stone. You can see we have got very detailed textures. So this is it. Hope you enjoyed the session. In the next session, we are going to create the leaves of the tree, and we are going to render all these maps in Maya by using Arnold. In between, if you have missed any of the sessions, all the links are given in the description, so you can check that. Don't forget to subscribe the channel for the future videos, and thank you very much for watching.